Okay guys, so let's start. So today class basically we are going to discuss about while giving interview, what you need to do, what you should not do, what are the things you need to discuss. Okay, so today we'll not be discussing any of your doubts and all, because there are couple of batches joined together, so that's why I told come to it and we will discuss all this stuff. Okay, so first of all, in the interview they are going to ask you, tell me something about yourself. So whenever you answer confidently, and always make sure smile is there in your face. Okay, you are not like you are telling, or you're stuck somewhere again telling. So prepare all these things that matters. Okay, and always make sure that you have a smile on your face. And sometimes it's very funny when I take interview, people started I joined there and all these things, that is fine. But especially I noticed, especially for some girls, whoever have break in between, so they discuss. You can tell, okay, I am not working for last 5 or 6 years, but you don't need to tell all this story. My went my husband went to on site, I went with him again, I was there, I was not working, coming back. Actually, I mean, it is not required. You can just say that due to some reason you have to take a break, or maybe because of you are expecting, so you have to take a break, you have to take care of your kids and also you are joining now, so you don't need to stretch it too much. Okay, because it doesn't make sense for others, right? You are not working for last 4 years, only I need to know that. I didn't know the whole details until and unless I ask you specifically. Okay, so make sure don't go into too much details. Just finish it within 2 3 seconds. You are in break and all. Okay, and whenever you are going to tell, you have to answer confidently. So first tell that my name is this. I am working as a QA engineer. So I have total this much of experience, and I have worked on different domain like this, 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 and I am working on Selenium web driver. Okay. Also, I have knowledge on TestNG, GitHub. I am very good in core Java. I am aware of the concept of inheritance, interface, polymorphism. So the reason I'm telling you have to read the mind of the interviewer and you have to redirect him what kind of question he should ask you. So if you already tell, I am aware of core Java, inheritance, interface concept, polymorphism, collection APIs and all. So you're already telling him, ask me the questions in and around that area. Okay, so those things you need to, but make sure you are confident enough. And before going off the interview also, you need to make sure that you are 100% okay with those concepts. As I told you, if you go and search for some interview question, that might not be helpful. That's why always I tell you, go with the concepts. First, make sure your concepts are clear. They might ask any question. Okay, nowadays people are not going to ask you to write much, what to say, program and all. Okay, yeah, definitely some programming concept they need to see. They might ask you what is a palindrome number, find out the factorial. Okay, add all the even number from 0 to 100. Okay, check some number printed in the reverse order. All these basic things they might ask you. If you go for search for some Java program and all, you can easily figure it out. Okay, so some basic things if you see, that is fine. Okay, but mainly they are going to go ahead with the concept. They are not going to ask you directly. At least I don't ask directly anyone. Okay, as I told you, instead of asking directly, the difference between C++ and Java, I told some question in Java. Like I told, there is a class called A, there is a class called B. In class C, I am inheriting from A and B. In the A, there is a method called XY, X and Y. In B, there is a method called X and Z. So in the C child class, I am calling X. From which class it is going to call? So immediately you have to say that no, your question is wrong, because the multiple inheritance is not supported in Java. So that's why I always force you guys. From the day one, I am telling you, go by the concept. Don't run behind the interview questions. Okay, that might help or may not help you also. I have some set of questions for you. Okay, but I can't guarantee all these questions will be asked from that. But if you go through the question, I am sure 90% question you can answer. If you are aware of the concept, if you have followed my class. Okay, if you are practicing. Or if you think you are not comfortable, don't look at the question itself. You practice for next 2 weeks. Then open my question document and see. Then you come back and tell me. Yes, there might be here and there. One question might be from here and there. I have not covered in the class. That can be possible. As I told you, there are 7,000 class interface methods. Right? So it might not be possible to cover each and everything. Right? But you can answer easily. If you don't know also, tell clearly. I am not aware of this part. But you know, I can figure it out because I am aware of the paper. If you can let me know the class name, or if I Google it out and find the class name, I can, from the documentation, I can see what are the methods available and I can easily write it. Because from there I'll get to know if that class is using any constructor or not, if the method they are having any return type or not. Okay. So your introduction part, you have to give it clearly. Prepare for it. Okay, don't be like that. I go and tell any what is there. No. Okay. And sometimes it happens that interviewer asking you something, he might be telling something wrong. Okay. So don't argue like this, no, this is wrong and all. Because sometimes if people know also, they might be say test lead or test manager, or you might be say joining as a senior engineer. So if you go with the argument, he knows, but he will, you know, give some feedback, that attitude, bad attitude. Especially that works with most of the Indians, I noticed. If someone is not aware, if that guy is telling something, they cannot take it as a, you know, easily. Okay, he might think you will not be able to, you know, work with the team and all. So you can tell your answer. If he is telling something, he told, okay, my understanding was like that, but yeah, so maybe I need to check into this part. So later, if he can figure it out, he is wrong, he definitely is going to recruit. Ultimately, you have to get into it. And remember, first 15 minutes is very important. First 15 minutes only you have to create the impression. Make sure don't hesitate, you know, don't be like, you know, too much of formal. Yeah, one more thing, don't call anyone sir, madam. Don't be too much of formal in this industry. People don't like it. They will first handshake you, tell you name. Make sure that you remember the name. Okay, because if you ask, you know, call by name. Okay, I definitely, if I take an interview, I'll tell my name is Abhishek and all. Then if you want to ask me something, you can tell Abhishek what I mean, please. Okay, don't call by surname. Don't be too much of formal. Because too much of formal, you know, it's not going to work in the IT industry. Okay, so all these things you need to make sure. And as I told you, first 15 minutes is important. You have to drive the interviewer from which, what are the topics he is going to ask you. So tell clearly, say, if you ask me, I'll tell something like this. Say, my name is Abhishek. I am in this industry for last 14 plus years. I have worked on different automation tools like UDP, OATS, Selenium and all. I have very good knowledge on core Java. I am aware of, you know, all the core Java concepts, inheritance, interface, polymorphism, abstraction, method overloading, overriding, all these things. So I can work independently. I have worked on the framework like page object model or category keyword driven framework. Okay. Then along with that, I have integrated TestNG, Git, Jenkins, Maven. Okay. So I am aware of all these things and I have worked on these domains. I have worked on CRM domains for last 5 years. Before that, I was in insurance domain. Earlier that, I was in some gaming domain. No, in the introduction part, don't talk about your project. Okay. So that's it. You just tell the domain. These are the domain I have worked. This is first started. This is your name is this. This much of your experience. You have knowledge on this tool. And then these are the domain you have worked on. Then let him ask the question. So when you talk about, you know, what are the technical skills you have, you put a focus on that so that you will drive the interviewer. Okay, ask me the questions in and around that area. If you have knowledge on database, and say I have worked on some database also, so I am comfortable with SQL queries also. So means you are giving him a hint. Okay, ask me the question, some SQL queries also. I am comfortable with that. Those things you need to mention. So first 15 minutes is very important. And make sure if you are going for an interview. So see, interviewer truly speaking is nothing but bluffing someone else. It only decide your CTC everything. You will see two person are going for an interview. Person two might have less knowledge than person one, but he is getting more salary. Because in the interview, he showed that confidence. Okay, and make sure whatever work they are going to tell you, if you are aware, it's fine. If you are not aware also, you have to tell that you can do anything. After that joining, if you can't do, that is a different thing. They will send you for training and all, but you can learn with your colleagues and all internally, or internally you can join some training, online training, like total 12 members, you know, including weekdays and weekend batch. Now all of you are joining today. So out of all of you, you know, some might be already working, some are okay going to switch, some are already working in Selenium, but they have to work in their project, so they are attending the training. Right, so all these things can happen. You can learn, you can join some online training, that you can learn. But when giving the interview, give them the confidence that okay, I know this tool. If there is some other tool also, I can work on it. If they tell you, no, we are not working on Selenium, or we are not working on this, we have different tool and all, so you can say, see, I know the object-oriented programming concept in Java, so most of the tools are based on that. It may not be Java, it might be different language, Python and all, but concepts are same, right? Object, constructor, inheritance. So I don't think it is going to take much time for me. What will be the difference? Only difference will be in the syntax part and all. Okay, so give them the confidence. They should get the confidence. Okay, and never, you know, try to prove that interviewer is wrong. They might, you know, sometimes they might ask you wrong question to see what's your reply, how you are going to reply for that. Like multiple inheritance, I told. So yeah, I remember I asked the same question one girl. Then when she was thinking, then I told, okay, tell me the difference between C++ and Java. First question, she told, multiple inheritance is not supported in Java, is supported in C++. I told then what was my question. Then she was look like me like this, okay, I did some crime asking these questions. Okay, I can read her face. Then I told her, you should tell me my question is wrong. Because if you search in here, everywhere you will get difference between C++ and Java. Instead of that, I am asking some questions. Then same interface, as I told you, you know, normally, I normally don't ask direct questions. I gave some example, I told them. Okay, always I normally follow them. Like for, I think I told you or not, I told like this, ABC, X equal to, you know, XYZ. So I told, out of ABC and XYZ, one is class, one is interface. Tell me, which one is class, which one is interface? Yeah, so definitely you can tell ABC is the interface, because we cannot create an object of an interface, right? So XYZ cannot be an interface, it has to be a class. So I told you one is class, one is interface. So if XYZ is a class, ABC should be interface. ABC can be class also, interface also. But I told you one is interface. Okay, so you might not get direct question, you might get indirect questions and all. That is the reason from the day one I am saying, make sure your concepts are clear. If your concepts are clear, you can ask. Be confident. Okay, and you can be confident if you are aware of the concept, if you study. Okay, so I am telling you again, first 15 minutes is very important. You have to put it in his brain, interviewer brain, what kind of question he should ask, what direction he should go. So you should focus, I am aware of, oh, I mean, instead of telling, you know, you are aware, oh, well, one more thing I forgot to tell you. You mentioned the manual testing also, because 90% people are working on manual and automation. Not 90%, I am saying, say, if whoever working in automation, hardly 10% are only working on automation. 90% people manual plus automation. Now you can say maybe 60-40, 70-30. Okay, so don't ignore that part. Some people are saying, no, I am only for automation, I am not aware of manual and all. So this is not good also. Okay, because nowadays everyone is following agile process. So in the agile, what you have to do, there will be sprints for 2 weeks and all. First week, maybe you have to test them manually and certify the product, log a bug, developer are going to fix it and all. Once they are going to fix it and all, next week, maybe you are going to automate those things side by side. Again, next sprint, some new feature will come, so old feature are already automated. So instead of executing manually, you can run the automation scripts. And again, next week, there you can automate it. Okay, so make sure you can tell, okay, I am comfortable with the test cases, also test case writing, test scenarios, reading the requirement document, writing my test cases. Okay, and writing. And if you are 5+ years of experience, you can tell you have an experience in test plan writing and all those. Normally, those are taken care of by leads and managers. Right? If you guys are AI, test plan is nothing but a document. What I share with the client, what are the things we are going to do in this project? What tool we are going to use? What are the things we can do? Okay, you can tell. If your experience is more than 7-8 years, you should put more focus on framework. Okay, you can say, you know, you are working on this framework, you have contributed to this framework, I have worked on this framework, I have developed this framework from the scratch and all. Okay, if your work is less, if you tell you have developed some framework from the scratch single-handedly, it will be a big problem. They can catch you. Okay, so answer, you know, whatever you are going to answer, first prepare, first see what experience you are going to show, what's your experience, what time you are going to show the Selenium experience. Correct? Like, you know, in my last class, Toshi, you asked me, right? You have worked last on 2011. After that, you are not working, right?
Yeah.
So while answering, you have to be careful. That time, WebDriver was not that much popular.
Yeah. Maybe okay. I can just mention ki in this break of my career, I just enhanced my knowledge on automation and with Selenium tool and taking.
Yeah, correct. So what's your total experience in manual?
5 years.
5 years. Okay. That's a good thing. You tell one thing.
Yeah.
You can tell you have worked on some internal automation tool which was based on Java. So you are aware of the core Java concept and you have worked on some tool. Give some name, you know, no one can figure it out. Like I used to work on Aditi Technologies, there was one tool called Atlas. The full form was Aditi Test Automation something. I forgot. That's that internal tool, someone developed it based on, which was based on Java. Okay, so Selenium is nothing but the same thing. It's just a different tool, different APIs, different function, different method name.
So
something like that also you can tell.
Okay, so if I say QTP, I have worked like for few months for QTP for some internal project. Will that be like good?
Tell QTP, but don't put more focus because you are driving interviewer to ask you that question.
Oh, okay.
So you can say, yeah, initially a couple of, you know, 6 months and all, I have worked on QTP long back, but I am not in touch with the QTP for long time. After that, I worked on some internal Java-based tool. Okay, so there I used all the Java concept, object-oriented programming concept, inheritance, interface, polymorphism and all. So after that, I was break from 2011. Now I'm planning to join again. So I saw in the industry, you know, it's Selenium now. So since I was aware of Java, I was very good in code Java and all. So it didn't take much time for me to start with the Selenium. I'm able to easily pick up.
So Abhishek,
so you are telling you are not working in Selenium, but you know, you have experience, you know the code Java concept and you can easily work.
Okay, so Abhishek, you tell like if you are 7+ years experience, then only we can tell like we have the knowledge of framework creation.
No, if you are 2-3 years experience also, you need to tell, because definitely they are going to ask you which framework you have used. If you are working on some project, you have to use some framework.
Okay,
but don't tell you have developed it from the scratch.
But if we are showing like we have worked mostly on manual testing, then can we say like we have worked on the framework too?
No, that's what you have to tell. If you are showing you are mostly worked on manual, you are just doing some automation side by side as a POC and all, that is different. You can't show too much here.
Okay.
But you are attending this training, I believe, because you guys are more focusing on automation and you want to get into that only.
Yeah.
Okay, that's the reason I am not focusing too much on manual. That's why I'm saying manual 30, automation 70 or 40, 60. Don't tell 100% automation. That is not going to happen.
Yeah.
Okay, nowadays hardly some companies are there, you know, where some people are working on 100% automation. One of the rare, you know, thing is in my previous project in my company only, there was one team which was dedicated only for automation. They are not doing any manual work.
But
it's
okay.
very rare because nowadays it's agile, everyone is following the agile process. You have
Yeah.
to test manually and all, then you have to automate it. Again, next you have to take the new requirements and all. So those are the things you need to keep it in your mind while giving the interview. So first decide, plan it. Don't go there and decide.
Abhishek,
Okay,
I have
what
one
time you
question.
are going to show your experience, what tool was there into the market and all. Like Toshi, for you, you can't show, you know, much web driver. You can say, you know, you started RC, but you have to stop in between, you have to quit the job. If you are aware of some high level of RC, or you can show other tool, and as I told you, so you will be more focusing on that core Java concept. You tell you are aware of the core Java concepts and all. Okay, so make sure you are aware of this thing.
So actually, I have started my career with Java only, but I didn't get many like much coding work in that. But I have
okay,
started
no
with
problem.
Java.
You don't need to tell all these things. Just you
okay.
tell that you started, you know, with the Java. Then
So,
you didn't get. You work as a Java developer. Then you worked on. Then they have switched you to the testing project. You have worked on testing as well as QTP. Okay,
okay.
later you have worked on some internal tool, they pulled you because you are aware of Java. So you worked
okay.
on that internal tool, Java based tool. After that break, you were studying the Selenium.
Okay.
Okay, Shilpa, we are not able to hear you. Maybe you can rejoin.
Hello, now?
Yeah, now we can hear you. Tell me.
Yeah, I was asking that when you said we can tell about our experience in manual testing. So, we can talk about our manual testing experience also when we get the interview. So if they are listening to that, then I think we can continue. But if they are preferring more of knowledge on automation, then how to drive the interview from there on?
See, if you don't have any knowledge of automation you want to show, then why you are attending this training? First question. It will be completely waste, right? If you are not showing.
Yeah,
you can go as a manual tester.
Yeah, true.
This you are attending because you want to show some experience. So what normally most of the people do, like for your case, you are working. Okay, currently also. Right? So you have said total 5 years of experience.
No,
no not
working.
You. I am asking here in the
oh,
class.
Okay. Oh,
okay. So in that case, what he or she, someone who is working, what they can show, they can tell, okay, I have total experience of 4 years. Okay. I have started my career with a manual testing. Now, currently, any one project you can select and tell that this is the project where I am working. I am using Selenium. And you have to see this project very clearly. What is the timeline of that project? What you are mentioning? Accordingly, you have to mention. Duration, exactly. Okay, and one more thing, you have to mention the WebDriver version also. You can say, if you are check what is the release date, you know that page, right? I showed you. You can say, I used to work on WebDriver 2, now I am working in WebDriver 3. And they might ask you the version also, which version you are working. Don't always go by the latest version. Latest version might be, you know, released 2 months back, 3 months back. Check that period, and you can say, okay, when I switched to WebDriver 3, we were using 3.1. Okay, after 6 months, we switch to 3.5 or 3.7. Now that project is still 3.7. We have not upgraded it. Okay, so make sure all this version and everything you are aware. They continue with that for a long time. They are not going to upgrade every month. Who knows, there might be some issue. After 6 months and 1 year, they will decide, okay, now we are almost 10 version, you know, earlier. We have to upgrade it. So one or two members, they have to run some Senate, they have to make sure everything is working with the latest version. Then they will say, okay, let's upgrade it. Now everyone is going to upgrade. Or they will give some pilot run with the latest version and they will see what's the percentage and all. Also, one more thing, don't tell anyone that in your project 100% test case you have automated. Okay, there are hardly projects are there where you can automate 100% test cases. Average 80% you can automate, 80-85 higher side. So don't tell all 100% test cases are automatable. Now they might ask you if you have, you know, little bit more experience, 6+, 7+. Okay, how you are going to decide whether you are going for automation or not? Then you have to tell clearly. See, I have to see how many test cases are there, how many resources it's required to automate, and how many number of times we need to execute. If we need to execute very frequently, maybe every once in every 2 months, once in every month, I have to go with that. I have to go for automation. But if the test case I need to, execute once in a year, then maybe I need 5 days, for example. So you'll tell, see, for next 5 years, I need 5 days, 5 days, 5 days, 25 days. But to automate those, say in this, those 5 days, I am executing 2,000 test cases. To automate those 2,000 test cases might need 6 months. So you spent 6 months of time to automate, which you are going to run only once in a year. 6 month time, maybe, you can execute next 10 years also. So there is not much ROI, right? Automation is every month, say in my case, every month we need minimum 5 days, and we are releasing one on build every month. Okay, and that is going for last 3 years. Since we have automated it, we don't have to execute it manually. We are just giving error every month. If there is some new feature, we are automating it, adding it to the legacy test. So that's how you can, compare, and you can decide all these things you can say. Secondly, while preparing resume, you have to be careful. I'll be sharing this. So this is one of the resume which is very good. I'll be sharing. So see, this guy mentioned clearly 8 years of experience in information technology and all experience in this, sound knowledge on JUnit, TestNG framework. First, mention all these things, the technical things, whatever you are aware of. Okay, then slowly you can go to the other things you have. See, he or she mentioned that things also, manual testing also. Test and writing, executing test cases, manual testing, automation execution, using Jenkins and all these things, compatibility, browser testing. So all these things normally I don't read also in the resume. I just try to focus on the technical part. Those things mentioned at the beginning, first write the experience clearly. This is also not good. Sometimes, I search what's the total experience. Okay, and I'll be in different mood. You don't know, I might 5 days some developer and came to take the interview, or I don't have time, manager forced me, no, you have to go and take the interview. I'll be in different mind. And after that, if I search in the resume, what's the total experience, I'll get irritated easily. And you don't know in the office, how people will be. And there is one more thing, and that is very important. When you go for an interview, okay, if they ask you some preferred timing and all, try to attend the interview as early as possible. People will be in fresh mind, they will just come to office and all. Later, they will be in hurry, they might not have time, someone will force you, no, you go and take the interview. Or they have to finish something, they have to deliver today itself in the meeting. They have to take the interview. So that also matters. Okay, so anyway, I was talking about that resume. This resume I find is very good. See, he mentioned clearly, then he mentioned technical skills. Okay. See, testing Selenium, WebDriver, RC, IDE, Gridio. Choose carefully what are the things you are going to mention. Qt, PHP, languages, what he is aware, test framework, methodologies, and all this stuff. Okay. After that, they mentioned their project. When you mention the project, don't give too much of description. That actually no one is bothered to know about your project. And some US-based company, they are not going to recruit you also. They'll say, this guy is mentioning everything in his project. Tomorrow he is going to mention everything about my project. So people will be aware in the market. Just mention one or two liner maximum about your project. Believe me, I will be least bothered to know about your project. I don't have any interest. Okay. So when I ask people, to explain to, and one more thing, when they just ask your experience, don't start explaining your project at all. If they ask, explain, but very high level. Don't tell there is this module. When I log in, it goes to this page. There I can see all these things. I do these things. It will go take me to this page there. I mean, they will get bored. Just mention two, three lines in there, go to more details. Some people are there, same. I mean, you might go for automation interview. People are completely from manual background. They don't know anything about automation. So they might go sometimes in between your projects in details, what things find out. So that time that is a different case. But if their recruitment is for automation, they will focus on automation. So they are not bothered much about all these things. Okay. So make sure all these things matters. Then mention, see, in the project, see, this guy is what he did. He mainly mentioned his roles and responsibilities. So to mention what's your role, what's your responsibility in this project. Okay. So if you have more experience, you can say you are involved in designing part and all also in the framework. So you have designed it, and don't tell you have you are the only person who designed. Tell that, you know, that as a team you decided and all this stuff you did and all. So like this you did. And your role was to like creating the, if you are creating the pages, you know, writing the functions and all, then writing the test cases. Okay. And the test engine, all they might ask you, I mean, definitely you can answer all these things. And these are not key, every day you are configuring, you will be configured once, right? So I am aware, you know, each and every step. The reason is I'm, you know, taking these tuition classes and I am doing every batch. Otherwise, imagine I have done, I could have done it in 7 years back. Last 7 years, I will not be installing test engine. So I can suddenly say how to install. Okay. Grid, as I told you, if you want, you can skip. 95% of the companies, they are running the automation test cases in any single browser. Some companies, they might be running in two browser. Three, I have not heard. Because see, you will automate, but to make your script, all the script 100% pass is a very tedious job. Don't say that whatever I am automating, it's running fine, everything is going fine now. There will be some issue, some network issue. Sometimes there will be change in the URL, some expert will change, something will fail. Okay, in the night you will be running in lights out mode, maybe page didn't load properly. All these things might happen. Okay, so you can say, yeah, we are getting 85% possible. Then they will say, how many test cases you are automating per day? Don't claim any number. You check what project you are going to show. Check how big the test cases are. Okay, it can be one, it can be five, six. Okay, you can say, okay, it's not constant and depends on the test cases. Like initial test cases, my test cases, you know, are all related to data setup. Like login, invalid login, and all I have to test. So those I can, you know, in one day I can test, I have automated 5-6 also. But later I have to automate one test case is nothing but one full scenario. So it takes whole day to automate it, sometimes 1.5 day also. Okay, like this you can answer. Okay, so see this resume, he mentioned all roles and responsibilities instead of, you know, mentioning too much of details in his project and all. He just mentioned the project name, timeline and all. And see, why I selected this resume. If you see his initial resume, initial project. If you see his initial projects, see, he didn't mention at all anything about automation. It's not like you join somewhere and they will put into automation. You'll be starting with manual, you'll be doing some manual work, then you will slowly move to the automation. Okay, so make sure all these things, okay, keep all these things in your mind and prepare the resume properly. Highlight the things, whatever the things you need at the top. Okay, don't let them search what technical skill you have. If you want those test engine JMeter, second and third point, you can mark it as a bold color also. Or if you don't mark it as a bold color, you don't need to highlight, it's fine. Like this, you can mention one technical skill. So they will just focus on the technical skill, I can figure it out. Don't write too many descriptions, people don't want to read. Put a bullet point and write. That will be basically make your resume more readable format. Okay. These are the things, preparing resume clear. So first put your experience and all. Definitely in the resume top, you will be writing your phone number, name, email ID, and all those are the things. Yeah, it's a part of all the resume. Highlight it. Then summary and technical skill, you put it properly. After that, whatever you put your project, that's up to you. They might ask you how many team members are there in your project and all. So if you are following agile, so don't tell that we have 10 QA engineer, all our automation guys and all. If you have this kind of scenario, that is different. Otherwise, don't tell that it's an agile team. So our whole project was divided into small 4-5 teams. Every team there are 2 QA and say 5 developers. So you can say average 7%, but yeah, it can be 6, sometimes it can be 9 also. Okay, depending on the work and all, they are shift switching from different team to different team. To tell that we both are working and manual and we are writing test cases. So you are telling, okay, I can write the test cases. I can go through the requirement document, write my test cases also. Then I can execute manual testing, then I am automating it. So you are open, you are opening the door for both. See, 100% nowadays, 100% cases, you will get the requirement manual plus automation. But hardly 30% companies will get an opportunity to work on automation as well as manuals. Remaining 70, though they will ask for automation, you will put complete into manual. Those things are also there. But yeah, if you are, like I have to work on automation, if that is the thing. So don't tell you are working only on automation. So you just ask politely. Okay, so can I get an opportunity to work on automation also, or it's for manual? Because I need both and all. And if they ask you the reason for change and all, don't tell anything bad about your company. Don't tell anything bad about your managers and all. Okay, so you say that, I have been working for this project. So initially, I worked for automation and all. Now there is not much automation. We have automated everything. So that's why I'm looking for more opportunity, more challenges. That is the reason I'm looking for it. I might ask you why you want to, why. Okay, one more question. Nowadays, people are having a lot of offers and all, if you are from automation background. Okay, so they will ask you, okay, whether you are going to join or not. So this type of question they ask. You can ask, because before, attending the interview only, I pulled it out and checked about your company. So I think that, there are a lot of opportunities so that I can utilize my skill, or I can learn some new thing also if there is some new thing. So that's what I saw in the net and all, googled it out. I saw in the some Glassdoor.com or somewhere, you can say, I saw the review. That's the reason I came for an interview. Okay, so if I get an opportunity, definitely I'll, give my best, and because I always happy to learn new things. Okay, and they might ask you what are the things you are doing in your free time when you don't have much work in office and all. So decide all these things, get some web page name and all, like maybe javatutorial.com and all. You say that I'm going through those tutorials, I'm reading blogs and all these things. Okay, so all these things I'm spending my time. Basically, they want to see whether you are utilizing your time or not. And make sure you are aware of all the upgraded latest version, whatever is there into the market. You may not be working, but this is the latest version and all. Like this December 25th, they are releasing a new version. Did I told you Selenium 4? Okay, so yeah, you don't need to tell you have worked on it. But if you are aware, maybe you will be attending interview in Jan only. I don't think before that companies are going to recruit anyone. You can say, I know there is Selenium 4 release into the market, but I have not yet worked on it. Or if you get a chance, you can work on it and you can say, I just tried for my own interest, but in my company, we are using Selenium 3.7 version or 3.10 version. Okay, so they will be aware, okay, these guys are aware what is there into the market, even he tried also for his interest. He is ready to learn new things. These things are very important. Now come to the framework, don't mention multiple frameworks. Mention any one framework. Here, you guys can mention page object model framework. As per the requirement, don't change it. If there is an opening for capability framework, if you are aware of the say page object model framework also, my main focus will be to figure it out what's your contribution in that framework. What are the things you are going to use? Whether you are aware of the framework or not, structure. If that is fine, I know you can work on any of the framework. So I showed you, right? Page object model framework is ultimately the two part in the diagram, right? One is all the test cases. One is all the pages. That's it. For KWD also, one will be QR file, one will be test cases. Apart from that, whatever I did using properties file and all reading, writing Excel, which test case I need to run and all, It you can do it with any framework, right? So those things are common, basically. Data driven, keyword driven, whatever. So those things you can integrate with any framework. If they ask more about your framework, then only start drawing and explain. Otherwise, don't simply start, you know, draw and explain. Okay, so try to read the mind, what's his mood, what he's trying to understand, what he's trying to know, and all these things. Okay, so again, I'm telling you, first 15 minutes is important. You have to drive the interview or whatever question you need to ask. Put more focus on those. I am aware of the test scenarios. I am writing test cases day by day. Okay, then I am automating it. I am aware of the core Java concept. I am using TestNG framework. Along with TestNG, I am using ANT, XSLT. Okay, we use Maven. And for storing the, I am using Git, GitHub. Okay, using Jenkins, I am running my scripts. So basically, you are telling him all the keywords, what are the things you are aware, and you are driving him, ask me this question. If you want to be more specific, yes, like, so Kashi, you can tell, okay, I am aware of the core Java concept, I am aware of all these object, constructor, inheritance, interface, polymorphism, abstract classes, and all. So you are telling him, okay, boss, these are the things you asked me question. Okay, so you have to be aware of all these things. Okay, so I'll be sharing this resume, and make sure you are also aware what are the things you need to tell and all. Prepare it, practice one or two times, it will help you. Okay, don't be like that, okay, I'll ask if I know they are going to recruit me. No, that is also matters. Maybe you can pretend there, you can go there and behave like this, you have not prepared and anything, but make sure you are aware which project you are working on, what is the timeline, how many team members, which project you are working in automation, if there are multiple projects. Okay, what are the pages, little bit high level in case they ask. And don't go at all into the details until and unless they ask which button you click, which page is landing, what you are doing and all. That no one is interested about your project. Okay, as some of you are asking for some interview questions also, I have one document here. But I believe 90% question you can answer. It's some basic, like, you know, that also I have collected from some internet only. Okay, just for you to share with you guys, what is automation testing? What are the benefits of automation? What type of test you have automated? How many test cases you are going to pay? What is the framework? Okay, have you created any framework? See, if you are a beginner, no, I didn't get a chance to create a framework. I have used the framework which is already available. If you are within 2-3 years. Okay, if you are an experienced tester, yes, I have created a framework, or I have involved in creating a framework. That is, you know, the best answer. I have involved in creating a framework. I have created means you have created everything. Hello. Instead of that, no, as a team, we have worked on it. We have created something. Okay. So, and try to, you know, say that since you are a good learner and all, they are trying to pull you in some good projects and automation. Like in case of Toshi, I told you, right? See, you can tell since I was from Java development background, whenever, you know, the internal tool, what I worked on, they pulled me. Okay, there are a lot of queries that they pulled 2 or 3 of us. Because we are from, you know, Java background, we are aware of the Java, so they thought, you know, they were having that confidence that easily we can work on it. So they can figure out, okay, out of these 10, these 1 or 2 people, you know, they are some higher level. They pulled you there for some reason. So like this indirectly, you can highlight yourself. So think about it, how you want to do it and all. What timeline you are going to show you have automated, what version was there into the market. All these things you think and then go for it. Okay. So can you explain the framework which you used in Selenium project? You know, why did you prefer Selenium automation tool? It's free open source, you know. Okay, they might ask you, okay, we have an opening for Python with Selenium, not with the Java. Okay, so if you are not interested to go, that is a different thing. But if you think, no, I can go and learn what's there. So you can tell, yes, this is true, I am not aware of Python, but I believe I am aware of all the OOPS concept. Mention them. All the Java OOPS concept, and these OOPS concepts are same for all the languages. So if I work on Python also, definitely I can work. Only thing I need to learn the syntax. Concept wise, I don't have to learn anything new. And if you are like, no, I learned Java, I don't want to learn Python and all, that is a different thing you can say. No, I'm mainly looking for Java with Selenium. So in case they ask, okay, the opening is only for Python with Selenium. Sometimes what happens, they don't find much people with Python. So that are local, let's recruit them only. If they can work with Java, they can work with Python. Okay. Now, what else? See, what is Selenium? These are the basic things. What is Selenium ID? What is Selenius? Okay, Selenius is nothing but the command in Selenium ID. So one more thing, I told you guys, right? Selenium ID is not supported now. Latest version of Firefox is supporting. But there are very basic features. Okay, same thing. You go Google it out, download Selenium ID. Okay, you can just click on it. It will add a plugin in the Firefox. You click on the record button, you will just do the recording. So you have my old ID, what is that? ID videos, right? So it's the same thing. Catalan recorder also, it is also based on Selenium. Catalan, then what else, Siculi and all these things. Those are on the top of WebDriver. Basically, they are make your life more easier. See, WebDriver is making your life more easier. They have created all the function method, everything. Right, to get, to open the URL, get text, which will capture the text. But actually, they are using Java. On the top of that, you have WebDriver. Now, on the top of WebDriver, they are developing different tools. So those tools, APIs are, you know, talking to WebDriver. WebDriver is talking to Java. Catalan and all, those things you don't have to, you just need to record. And you will see your WebDriver scripts. When you open the scripts, you will see your WebDriver scripts. So you don't have to write basically. Instead of writing, you are recording. So if you know WebDriver, that is nothing for you. Okay? Then these are the all the things. What else? Yeah. What are the different locator and all? What are the difference between SS verify? All these things I told, soft assertion, hard assertion. Basically, I just, you know, went through high level. I also didn't check each and every question. After going through high level, I saw that, you know, you guys are aware of everything here. One more thing they are going to ask. Why we are using like this? I'm just copy pasting. They are saying, see, I can write, right? Firefox driver, driver equal to new Firefox driver. Chrome driver equal to new Chrome driver, right? Instead of that, why most of the people are using WebDriver driver equal to new Firefox driver or WebDriver driver equal to new Chrome driver? Basically polymorphism concept, right? So why people are using like this? That is one of the questions. Can you guys tell me? Why most of the time I am using WebDriver driver equal to new Chrome driver instead of Chrome driver equal to new Chrome driver? Yes. See, if I use Chrome driver equal to new Firefox driver, I want to make driver global, right? Tomorrow I need to run it for different browser. I need to run Firefox driver equal to new Firefox driver. But I have to declare globally like this, right? And here I can only use driver equal to new Firefox driver equal to new Chrome driver within if else condition, right? Correct. So if I here write Chrome driver equal to new Chrome driver, it will be Chrome driver equal to new Firefox driver, right? It's not going to work, right? So that I can put if else condition and I can declare the driver globally, driver instance. And internally I can say whatever the browser I am going to mention in the properties file, it will read and execute that. So driver will be the same for all. So if I specify Chrome, Firefox, Safari, it will be only for that browser, right? That's what I don't want to do. Dibba, you are not clear? Huh? Got it, right? That's the reason we are using driver, WebDriver driver equal to new Chrome driver, new Firefox driver. Instead of hard coding it for particular browser. So that is one more practical use, you can say polymorphism. You guys are asking me, right? Where exactly I can use, what is the actual use? Here also you can see. Okay. And what else? I think everything is there. Web weight and all, input text, different things, get attributes and all, how to pause the test script for 5 minutes, chat dot sleep. Difference between driver dot get and driver dot navigate dot to. Remember, one is for browser backward. Navigate dot to, when we use, it will track your browser history also, right? Browser cookie also. So that if you click on back button and forward button in the browser, it can take you to that page. Okay. So yeah, I think, you know, I just went to high level. I feel, I mean, I tell every batch, you go through it, and if you have any doubt, ask me. So people are not coming back to me. So that's what I didn't go through, bother to go through all this question. So I just assume that everything is covered in the class. Or maybe, you know, they figured it out if something is missing. Because you know all the concept, you just need to know some high level. Okay, so if you also don't come back, I am assuming that everything was covered, or you can figure it out by yourself. Okay, select drop down and all. Try catch block. Yeah, scrolling and all. Yeah, everything is covered. Okay, so these questions I am sharing, you will get some questions definitely out of it. But again, I am telling you, if you followed my class, if you understood all the concept, 90% question you can answer. Remaining 10%, I don't have any control. Okay, 10% thing you can answer. So that's why this class I scheduled mainly for interview and all, how you have to prepare and you resume and all. I told you this is not for your doubt clearing and all. If you want one session for doubt clearing, as I told you, you guys can go through it for next 2 weeks, 3 weeks. Okay, then you can communicate with each other and let them know we need one more class. Okay, I will not be there in that group, because again, every month there will be new group. It will be too many groups. Okay, so I'll be log off from that group maybe within next 2-3 days. I will see if there is any doubt, anything from your end. Okay, and I think she'll be collecting your resume, right? You have already collected some. Maybe they can upgrade now if they want. Okay, accordingly upgrade. Share it your resume. If you have any doubt, let me know. And as again, I have started one more batches, so you are always welcome to join any batch. Yeah, you just need to call her and tell that I am from this batch. I need to go through this class. No issues at all. Don't hesitate.
Okay.
So you are always welcome. As soon as you know you can learn, you are interested to learn, you are not clear, I am here. I am in this institute for last 4-5 years. Okay, so yeah, other institute I joined, quit and all, but this I am continuing for 4-5 years. Okay, so you are always welcome. You can come join any batch, attend any class, any topic, particular topic you need to go through. You just need to call her and tell. That's it. Okay, so only thing you need to figure it out, the timing you have to maintain. Okay, what timing, you know, I have this, I normally figure it out with that batch. Okay, so that's not an issue. Anytime, any doubt, you can ask me. If something is new, I'll be also happy to learn that thing. I can learn, I can tell you, and I can include it in my, you know, course content from the next batch. So that's how it is like this.
Actually, one more I don't very much aware about it. To open that browser, that in driver manager something.
I think you are talking about Firefox profile. Okay, I'll come to that. Okay. Okay, guys. So whoever you know joins online, any question, any doubt, you got it? What to do, what not to do?
Abhishek, I have a question. So do you think, yeah, like for core Java, if we do any certification like Oracle certification for Java, will that help?
Definitely. But see, if you are aware, I mean, if you do, it's fine. If you don't do also, I think first you try it out. Don't again wait for that completing the certification and all.
Okay. Yeah, no,
okay,
not completing.
I mean, don't think that, okay, I'll finish the certification, I'll search. You can do side by side, but you know, put your 100% to searching for jobs and all. Don't wait for that to complete. Okay, you can mention maybe in your resume you are doing the core Java certification and all something.
Okay.
Okay. So Shilpa, I noticed you are, you know, joining and going offline. There might be some issue, but don't worry. This session is recording. We are recording this session. Okay. You can go through it also. You can
sure. Sure, Abhishek. And in case I have any queries, I'll WhatsApp you.
Yeah, definitely. You can WhatsApp me, come to the class in the weekend.
Yeah. Mainly my experience is in manual testing, embedded testing, multimedia and setup box. So I have had
so
in my
most
resume.
Of the people are from manual only. So figured out any project, fix a timeline. And
okay.
Decide that okay, this is the timeline I am going to show. I have worked on automation. You sure. can show your same project, just you will tell sure. that you have automated this. You will just change the sure. roles and responsibilities in this project. Let the project
sure.
be seen.
Okay.
Okay, because sure. in the market, if I give you some project, it is not going to help. By seeing the project, people yeah. can figure out oh, it's a fake project. That's why I tell everyone, whatever the projects you are working on, pick up any one of the projects and tell that you have automated it.
Yes.
Okay, that will be the best thing I feel. Yeah.
Yeah, so we already have a framework in place on which the automation team is working. So what I was doing is to learn WebDriver and Java. I'm automating few scenarios in stage on my own to see how it works because they use C# and I'm learning in Java. So I can, if I'm attending an interview for automation, then I can explain the same concept, right?
Yeah, okay. Tell that your framework is in place. We used Selenium Java. You are working on that framework. I mean, you have not designed from the scratch. You are working on that framework. You are designing different pages. You are writing the test cases. Okay, in the test engine and all, checking the reports. You are running your test cases every weekly, 15 days, whatever the process you are following.
Okay.
Okay, tell everything, but just don't tell that framework was based on C#.
Okay, fine.
Okay, because otherwise it will be confusing, right? They will say, okay, your framework in C# and you know Selenium with Java.
Yeah,
And
can
I have
you
some resume, 2 years experience, and in that resume they have mentioned they have worked on KWD framework, page object model framework, Herbie framework. Then I ask directly, see, this is not possible, whatever you have mentioned in your resume. So this resume is fake. Okay, so it's not possible. If you are working for 6-7 years, you can say, you know, 2 or 3 framework you are working on. Truly speaking, you know, I am working on one framework only 5 years in my office, KWD. So here outside people are asking for page object model because that is top of all the framework. Page object model, right? Yeah, because it's the top part in my project. There is no option to use page object model because in my project there are more than 1,000 pages. Okay, so it's not the right, you know, framework to use. Because of you guys, I have learned. I have to tell you guys. But I thought the concept what I used in my KWD, I implemented it here also. Yeah, what are the difficulties you are facing? You can say, yeah, we are facing. If you are experienced holder, you can say, yeah, we are facing difficulties while designing the framework. You know, how to manage, how to remove redundancy and all. How can we share the same driver instance and all. If you are less experienced, you can say, to identify some object, we face a lot of difficulties. Objects are having ID, name, we tried with all these things, expert, nothing is working. So finally, you know, I have to start from some parent position, I have to write my own expert. So you can say, yeah, I can't explain you technically why it is not working. Though I am giving the idea, it's not working. So I started from his parent or 2 level up and I gave the, you know, relative expert instead of using directly ID. Then it worked. So those things you can tell. Then you can say page loading issue we have faced. There is a page loading issue, sometimes timeout and all. So those things are there. That also you can say. Okay, and don't use grid. You before using grid, you have to be, you know, think multiple times, because grid means running in different browsers. But one more thing, Selenium is a functional automation testing tool. I told you day one. So running in different browser, basically you are trying to verify whether every browser page is loading correctly or not. Basically UI part, functionality will be same. That Selenium cannot identify. If one button is displaying in the top of the page in Firefox, in Safari, if it is displaying somewhere else in the left side, still Selenium will be able to identify, because property will be same, right? ID, name. So ultimately, you are not testing browser, you are testing functionality only, but in different browser. So that is the reason I told 90% company using single browser. Like when we are using, if you can tell one more thing, if you are showing the experience, you are working in Selenium 2 and 3. But again, I am telling check the timeline. When you are working on 2, you are using Firefox, because that is the primary browser. In 3, they switch to Chrome. Chrome make as a primary browser. So we also did the same thing. We used to run it in Firefox. Now we are running it in Chrome when we upgraded to 3. Okay, so it's not a browser testing tool, it's a functional testing tool. So don't tell we are running multiple browsers, 3-4 browsers and all. It's very difficult to, you know, explain and convince them to believe you. You can say if you are comfortable using grid, or you can say no, we are not using grid. That is absolutely fine to tell like this, no, we are not using grid in my project, but I know the configuration and all, I have configured it. I can talk about that also. I can explain you also if required. Means they will understand, okay, if since we are using grid, this guy can work. Though they are not using, he did it. So he's interested also, you know, learn new things though they are not using. Something like this. Okay.
Abhishek, like sometimes we are asked, if you have worked on any critical issue and what was your role. So how to answer that?
See, you can, in terms of manual, you can think what are the things you can answer. Like that question was asked to me also long back. So I was working on one manual project. So after 2 years or 3 years of experience, I just switched to Aditi Technologies. That time they asked, what are the critical issues you have worked on, you faced? So what I told, actually that's the truth. I was upgrading, you know, there was a third party customer. So I have to run some job which upgrade my data to the third party customer website, so that my same data can reflect to their website, they can see. In that data, you know, in some columns, some values, there are some ASCII characters. Because of those characters, the jobs were failing. It was not able to upgrade that. So I tried a lot, that job were failing, you know, erased a bug and all. I mean, developer also are not able to fix it. That job were not able to take any ASCII value. Not ASCII value, sorry. Special character. You can see some character, right? A on the dot at the top, B on the top of the B, there are two dots. Some character we can see, right? Those junk character. They are not able to upgrade that job. So finally, I have to go to the database. I have to, you know, using some query, I have to figure out what are the junk character. I have to remove those character, upgrade those field. I have to do like this. So those are the issues I face. So in automation also, if you want to answer in terms of automation, you can say, yeah, initially we faced a lot of issues to run our test case parallelly and all, because the driver we were deciding, it was not running parallelly and all. Maybe somewhere, you know, it was using the same driver. Okay, so later I told you, right, how to share the same driver instance and all. And so that took time for me, you know, to understand and to figure it out, how to run parallelly, because I have to share the same driver instance and all. So in terms of automation, you can answer that. You can say I was getting at some point null pointer exception. It was opening the browser, not typing the URL. So because the driver was not shared properly. So that took time. I have to put my debug point. I have to check. So in that, you are telling that you have debugged also. You have a debugging skill also. I have checked where, what was the issue and all. Finally, I figured out that it is the single driver, so that parallel test case execution was failing. That you can tell, or you can tell, you know, identifying some object, I faced a lot of issues. So finally, I have to use JavaScript click. I told you, no, JS click. Something like this you can tell. Clear? Any more question? Nothing. Okay, so I hope this will be helpful for you guys. I'll ask Durga to share the recording also. So you go through the recording, prepare your resume. In case you have any doubt, anything, you can always reach to me. Okay, and I hope this will be helpful for you. Now you guys are confident. You can apply for a job. You will not hesitate if you see some, you know, openings on automation or Java.
Yeah, sometimes on Google.com, they require a lot of.
There will be a lot of tools. They also, you know, aware that one person will not be aware of all. If you know the, you know, couple of tools, that's fine.
Apply.
If you see at least, you know, 50% tool you are aware, I suggest you to go ahead and apply. See, now you know Java. REST API also is nothing. There is nothing but some class in Java. So how to access the method from that class? To create the object of that class access. Now, if you access in some method, what you need to pass? You need to pass some parameter. Maybe you are sending get request and all, you have to pass the URL and some parameter. So I don't think you need to learn it again. You can easily work on it if it is required. So you can tell like this. See, and since I am aware, I believe, you know, I can use those. I am aware of all these concepts, so I can use it. If it is REST or anything else also, or if it is even any other tool also, based on object-oriented programming concept. Use this word while giving your introduction, object-oriented programming, inheritance. Force them to ask the question on those areas. If they spend half an hour with you and they are getting correct answer, then, you know, chances will be very less that they are going to reject you. They already spend half an hour time with you. If they are going to reject within 15-20 minutes, they will decide and they will reject. If they cross half an hour, so for half an hour, 15 minutes is critical to ask you what kind of question, you create an impression. Then half an hour time will be, if you can cross, you can say, okay, I am done, or kind of. Okay, if you don't know, tell them clearly, if you don't have any idea. Yeah, clearly, I don't have any idea on that, or if it is something related, yeah. I think this can be something like this, I can learn.
Abhishek, I had one doubt.
One second, Shilpa. That's what I told, na? It can be 5 also, it can be 1 also, it can be less than 1 also. Based on the criticality, you can say at the beginning of the test plan, I was able to automate 5-6. Because these are some basic login, different login, invalid, valid login, or simple data creation. But later in my test cases, I have to use those data and test my scenarios. Those scenarios are very big. So later it was one test case per day, sometimes not even one test case also.
And how to the answer for how many bugs you have found so far? 2 years of experience.
Then you can say, yeah, I'm frequently logging, I didn't count much. But yeah, average, you can say, if you are telling you are working on some sprint, you can say average every sprint I'm, you know, minimum 5 bugs time, you know, logging. Okay. Per sprint, 5 I'm logging average. Yeah, Doshi?
Yeah, so one more question I remember. So, sometimes they ask, like, how do you start your testing and when do you say, like, testing is completed?
Yeah, so see, that is again kind of management questions. How do you start your testing? You can say, okay, some requirement comes, you have to go through the requirement. We have to write our test scenarios and test cases. And once it is ready from development end, also, we have to start our testing. And where to stop our testing? Yes, one software cannot be 100% bug free. These are all, it will come under manual itself, but I am telling you. You can say, so we have some parameter based on that we decide whether we are going to release this product or not. So first parameter is there, pass percentage should be more than 95%. Second parameter, there will be no P1 and P2 bugs. There can be P3 bugs, but there should be some limit. There should be less than, say, 5 bugs P3 and less than 10 P4 bugs. If we are meeting this criteria, we are certifying it. We are saying, okay, we are okay with this.
So Abhishek, which bugs, like generally we say like the most critical and set their priority, the severity?
That actually, by seeing the behavior, you can figure it out, right? Like something login is not working, that you are blocker, definitely. Even after logging some banking web page, if you say it's showing someone else's name instead of your name, that is a very important bug, right? Or some money transfer, you are transferring money, that itself is not working. Those are very critical functionality, right? While you writing the manual test case, you will identify the test case, whether it's a P1 or P2, P3 test cases. Some negative scenario, if it is not working, we are still okay. But again, depends on what kind of negative scenario. You are transferring money. If you type ABCD and if it is transferred, it's a P1 bug then. Though it's a negative. Because you can transfer a money amount with ABCD. Correct. So it completely depends on your project. You have to decide whether it's P1 or P2, P3.
So
I can give any specific example. It's based on your experience and all. You can figure it out. How important the functionality? How important this functionality for you?
Yeah. So in some projects, what I felt is all the functionalities, anyways, we have to test, and they should be like following the requirements, and they should be working. So normally we used to give like
error message. You are verifying error message may not be exactly the same. You didn't enter user ID password properly. It shows user ID password is wrong.
Yeah.
Instead of that, it might showing user ID password. Please re-enter the user ID password correctly. So that is not matching the requirement. But customer asked, user ID password is wrong. Yeah. That you can go ahead with P3. It's okay. It's giving me the error message. Not exactly what customer want. You can say, okay, since we don't have time, this bug will pick up later. As of now, release it, because people are waiting in the market for this software.
Okay. So most of the time, like, we can define their severity, criticality, like as 3, right? P3 and 3.
Not most of the time. See, if some functionality is not working, P1, P2.
P1, P2. Okay. But some of the functionality
like this, that is P3, P4. Some spelling mistake, P4.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah. UI part is always like low. But if it is a main page,
UI
part
high is
priority.
Yeah. If it is little bit here and there, it's okay. But if it is completely distorting, that will be again P1.
Yeah. Okay.
Abhishek, one quick question from my side. Mm-hmm. Can we ask the interviewer what is it okay? I mean, to ask what they're exactly application testing, the testers they're looking for what application?
That not at the beginning, at the end, they will ask, do you have any question? Yes, that is one more important. If they ask, do you have any question? Never say no.
Okay.
Always prepare something and ask.
Okay,
what kind of project I'll be working on? What's the domain? What will be my role? Whom I'll be reporting to? Okay, so the second round, see, I did that mistake. First round, they asked me this question, I answered. Second round, in my final round, the senior manager or director, he was QA director. He asked me the same question. I told, no, I don't have any doubt. So he laughed. Seriously, you should say. I mean, he already decided. I got selected. Then I told, no, actually, I asked the same thing in my second round also. So it was then how I should know that they asked you or not. You should always say you have some doubt. You should ask me the same question. He told me, because they have finalized that, okay, this guy got selected. Okay, let him tell. Okay, so if the same question they asked in multiple rounds also, you have to always say.
Okay.
Okay, don't say, no, I don't have anything. And better to go for an interview, just, Google it out a little bit high level about that company.
Abhishek.
Is there know about our company and what kind of company it is? You can say, yeah, definitely, because before coming here, you know, I have Googled it out. I checked the company. I have checked the reviews in the Glassdoor and all. If they are asking you, so are you okay with those things? You will say, definitely, that's why I am here. That's why I am attending the interview. Okay.
Do you have any sample test plan document, like maybe the major points that it should be there? Because I have
have some sample test plan test cases. Maybe I'll share it with you. Just ping me, okay? Test cases sample I have.
Yeah.
If you guys require, I can just share it with you. Earlier, you know, sometimes people ask me for some manual testing also. Nowadays, I don't take class on manual testing because I will not get time to manage. So whatever the things I used to share, I just, you know, saved it in my Google Drive. I can just share it with you. You guys can go through and check.
Yeah, because I have like forgotten the points, though I have prepared many test plans. But now, like, I have to recall what I'm only. I just need the points.
Definitely. I mean, I can share you the whole folder. You can download whatever you want and you can go through it and see.
Because if I get the points, I can recollect all my things, what I used to write.
Definitely. Absolutely. You are always welcome.
Okay. Thank you.
Abhishek?
Yeah.
Can you please ask the examples? Because since I am preparing the few test cases.
Hello.
Few test cases for manual testing. Since I am preparing myself, I am studying, so I need to know what are the things need to be prepared before attending this interview and all.
Okay, so you do one thing. You go through those things and maybe you call me later. Maybe one day I'll discuss with you.
Yeah, sure, Abhishek. Sure.
Okay.
Yeah, fine. Yeah, sure.
I'll talk to you. If you have some doubt, you ask me there. I'll explain or I'll see how I can help you out.
Okay, Abhishek. Okay. Yeah, sure. Yeah, sure.